In late 1954, Phillips arrived at work to find Johnny Cash sitting in the doorway, asking for an audition.
There was something in his voice, and I guess Sam heard it. He thought maybe he could make lightning strike twice. John wanted to be a gospel singer, and Sam didn't. He said, I can't sell gospel records. Write something that's not gospel, and I'll cut it.
Cash put a simple melody to a poem he had written about coming home on the train, Hey Porter, and began practicing with Luther Perkins on a borrowed electric guitar and Marshall Grant, who was learning to play bass. There's something squirrely about you guys, Phillips said when he heard their stripped-down style. But he admitted, it's different.
Hey Porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, will you tell that engineer to ring his bell and ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell?
They called themselves Johnny Cash and the Tennessee Two.
Hello, folks. This is Johnny Cash, and I'd like to introduce you to the other two boys here. This is Luther Perkins over here hitting all those hard notes on that guitar. Oh, go, Luther. And Marshall Grant hitting the low notes on this bass fiddle over here. And I have to strain my
eyes. But as that his voice is singular. Tennessee Two, that's like a punk band. You know, if you think about it, it's like, it's just like, you know, the bass is so percussive and Luther Perkins just playing like the four notes that seem to, you know, that he seemed to only know four notes. I literally think they sound like punk rock records. I mean that as the highest compliment. I mean, they're just so vivid.
Hey, Porter, please open up the door.
For a while, Johnny Cash and his fellow Sun Records artist, Elvis Presley, were sent out on tours together, mostly in the South and Southwest, opening for better-known country stars.
In 1955, I was a student at the University of Texas. I went down to the old Coliseum to see Hank Snow, who was my favorite at the time. And Hank had to cut his program short in order to let Elvis have a second show. As I watched Elvis, I thought, well, I thought I saw the beginning of the end of the music I loved.
Out on the road, Johnny Cash and Presley became friends. Elvis called Cash old man because Cash was 3 years older. Cash called Presley the shaky kid, and sometimes impersonated him on stage.
Well, it's down at the end of Lonely Street at the Heartbreak Hotel. You'll be so long. You'll be so long. You could die.
The term used to describe the music that had been born at Sun Records was rockabilly, and it was beginning to catch on.
Everybody knows where you go when the sun goes down. I think you only live to see the lights uptown. I wasted my time when I would try. 'Cause when the lights have lost their glow, you'll cry.
Fresh out of high school in Oklahoma City, Wanda Jackson had started out singing country ballads and cowboy songs.